What's up, guys? Welcome back to No Man's Sky. So, last time we got the rover built and we went exploring with it a little bit. Now we have the scanner built in, but the objective is to get the laser built and installed. And hopefully that is something I can do that doesn't require having to do like the construction guy or the scientist. What's up, dude? Exocraft signal booster, we can plan. Okay, I've got the signal booster is built in. Blueprints we promise, must prepare for everything eventually. Okay, so that's for Exocraft mounted cannon. Powerful weapon they can only fire from the Exocraft mount. Okay, I didn't know that there was a cannon. I thought it was just the laser. But either way, it doesn't matter. I've been playing so many different games lately that... Okay, so we have a power canister. Exocraft. We need power gel and a karite sheet. Two karite sheets. Okay. Well, that's unfortunate. How do I make, no, that's not what I wanted. How do I make power gel? Carbon and plutonium. Okay, that's not too hard. So we can just run outside and get that, and then we need iron, right? We need iron for, oh, God damn it. For karite sheets. 50 iron. How much iron do I have on me? I only see 8. Why are you... Is there my starship? Ooh, I have a lot of my starship. I guess because of my proximity I can make. Fucking hell. Okay, so... Can I not? Oh, you can't stack. Wait, you used to be able to stack these. I remember stacking these. Like, earlier in this series. Okay, well, carbon and plutonium to make power gel. So I can just shoot down a tree. And in theory, I have enough to make power gel. Yes. 50 and 100. Do I have plutonium on me? No. But I do have enough carbon on me. Sure. Okay. No big deal there. Are you going to go check out the tree I shot down? No. Okay, so now I should be able to install the weapon. But I don't remember it being a weapon. I remember being a laser. Okay, so install technology. Exocraft mounted cannon. Technology installed. Okay. Yeah, that is not the thing that I remember having. That is a weapon. That is not a mining laser. Okay, so we need to go talk to the guy again. No big deal. No big deal. I guess. I don't fucking know. Yeah, I know. Y'all are always upset about something. Dude, you gave me a cannon. I didn't want a cannon. I wanted a laser. Sentinel deposit in the world. Exocraft signal booster to track them down. Destroy the depot and bring back a precious armadium. It's for my work. I will construct an Exocraft acceleration module for future expeditions. Okay. So you need 70 of the... Okay. I guess. Do not worry, our lives are short, meaning it's fleeting. Yours will even be shorter if you know. Fuck you, guy! Okay, so. What? Wait. Okay, so. Okay, so the ship and the thing. So it's over there. Whoa, okay. What am I supposed to be doing right now? So he wants Armanium. This is Detritium. Detritum. Oh, whoa. Okay. So I'm not entirely sure what he's wanting me to do. Okay, so yeah, that doesn't do me any good. If I'm... See, that's the thing. Like, that says I need the mining laser. I should have the mining laser, not the mounted cannon. But, okay. Oh, hold on. I need to go talk to Guy again. Because I don't know what he wants. Hold on. I need to see if I can shoot this thing. Yep. Okay. That's interesting. Okay. So let's hop out. I need to talk to him again real quick because I just don't understand what he's asking me to do. He made it sound like he wanted me to go to a facility. Yeah, what did you want? Okay, I have detected sentinel deposit. This world using your Exocraft signal booster, track one down. Destroy the depot and bring me back the precious Armadium. I'm going to construct an acceleration module for future expeditions. Technicians require me to use Exocraft signal booster to locate the deposit and steal the Armadium from within it. It will use the substance to create an Exocraft acceleration module. Viking possesses an unusual obsession with those I have known as Sentinels. I have them looking over ancient script. Secret they discovered. What heresy has it committed? Okay. So I need to find a facility that has Armadium. And I need to use my Exocraft to find it. But he doesn't really give me any sort of direction. So I guess I just kind of have to hop in and go hunting. Not really sure what else to do. So I'm going to go exploring for a little bit. I'll get back with you if I ever figure out what the hell it is I'm supposed to be doing right now. Okay, I think I figured out where I'm supposed to be going. I haven't figured out the how I am supposed to get there. So I'm actually pretty far. Where are you? Okay, it's about 2 minutes away. And that's about 5 minutes away. Why am I hearing all the upbeat music? I shouldn't be hearing it anymore. So I have to get to that facility that's over there. It's about 2 minutes away. Ah, hell. One thing I do not like is how this thing steers, because like your character, it steers with the mouse. But when it comes to driving a vehicle with keyboard and mouse, I would rather it steer with WASD. Because then I can use the mouse to look around to figure out the best way to go instead of having to periodically stop. Now, I did get in a fight a few minutes ago with a couple of sentinels, and that might be why. Oh shit, I'm being triggered to go over here because I actually got in a fight with them and I scanned them before blowing them up, which was a lot easier with the cannon on this thing than it ever has been when I've been walking around. So I have been enjoying. Ooh, I do like having the rover. It feels a lot more personal than whenever you're going around in the ship on a planet. Like, if I wasn't, you know, going through space, obviously the ship is better. But whenever I'm actually on the planet, this feels better. Okay, and you were directing me here, so I'm gonna hop out and trigger this. I think I've already blown this place open. It looks like I've already destroyed this place. And that I apparently can't do anything else with it, so... I don't have an Atlas Pass. Oh yeah, this is annoying as all hell. I don't have an Atlas Pass. So I've already actually been here. Maybe that's why it popped up on my thing, is because I hadn't cleared it. I don't know. Supposedly I have to blow up something and get inside. I don't know what the hell I'm doing anymore. I saw... that way. So there's something over there. It'll take me 2 minutes on foot. It'll take me about 40 seconds on the vehicle, though. It's right over there. It looks like a drop pod. Oh, jeez. One thing I do also like about the rover, it can take a fall. It can take a fall a lot better than I can. So... but I want the mining laser. Undiscovered, so maybe I'll actually be able... okay, so let's hit this. Just to register the area. See about... where's the way in? There it is. Okay, I can't expand my bag here. 80,000. Okay. Whenever I find a place with the Ardanium, I'll get back with you. But as of right now, I'm really struggling to find it. I might have to even go as far as looking up what I'm needing to be finding in order to get it. But I'm going to search around a little bit more. I've already been recording longer than I wanted to be for something so small, but I'll be back. Okay, so I figured out what I'm looking for, and I had no idea that this is what these were going to look like. There are these canisters apparently spread throughout the area in different places. They're a little bit harder to find. They're not really marked well. But this is what I'm looking for. I was supposed to come out and destroy these, because these are what have... the material I'm looking for. The Armadium. And that was platinum. So... where? Okay. That's not what I wanted to do. Okay. This is what I wanted to do. Okay. So, I have 73, so I can head back to base, which is over there. Which is over 5 minutes away. I've just been hunting and hunting and hunting. There's apparently a drop pod over there, but... because it's marked the way it is, I think it's one that I've already gotten. Especially with how far it is and it being marked like that. So, we're gonna head back to base. We're going to get the booster, which I'm sure I'm going to have to install before he'll let me do anything else. So I'll get the booster and see about getting it installed. And hopefully after that, we'll be able to get the mining laser, because I really need the mining laser. Like, you see all these big boulders that are around everywhere. I can run them over and destroy them, but I don't get any materials when I do that. Oh, shit. I don't get any material whenever I do that. But if I hit them with the mining laser, it still destroys them, but I get material from them. And from what I can tell, it's actually a very valuable material. Even though there's just a fuck ton of it, it's because of how difficult it is to obtain, because you have to go through all these hoops to get items to be able to get it. So I'm going to head back to base. We're going to build the booster, which the booster is a good thing to have. It doesn't work really well with this rover. It works really great with the hovercraft that I eventually get. It works great with that, but with this one, it's just a nice little boost that you can occasionally use. But I still need that mining laser, and I want to have that mining laser before I end the episode. So I'm gonna get back to base. I'm gonna hit that drop pod that's right over there on my way, and I'll see you in a little bit. Okay, so we're back at base, dropped off the car in its little parking spot, and now it's turning the Armadium. Why is there suddenly just absurdly loud noise? What is that? I don't know why you have to growl at me, but okay. Alright, dude. Yes, it is in the vehicle. Can I transfer it? There it is. It's in my inventory. I don't see it in my inventory. There it is. It's in my ship for some reason. Now it's in my inventory. Okay. I did not realize I could do that at my base. Okay. Now I have your Armadium. I don't know why you can't take it from the vehicle, but whatever. Here you go. Armadium. I appreciate. Okay, what does this take? It takes Heridium and Armadium. I don't have any more Armadium. I'm gonna have to go hunting for more of that. Okay. What's next? I left my cornstone spawn behind a homeward traveler. Happened to them. Exocraft acceleration module. Wait, what? I must shed the last vestiges of my attachment. You will use the Exocraft acceleration module to reach their encrypted transmission before its deletion. In the process, we can pull Viking mining laser technology. Okay, so I can get the mining laser, but he wants me to go to some transmission tower. Okay, I don't need to use the Exocraft to get there, though. I can use my ship. Yeah, I don't need, especially when you're only going to give me like 4 minutes to do it. Okay, takes 9 minutes to run there. But if I take the ship, oh shit. Where is it? I take the ship, it only takes about 30 seconds to get there. There's no reason for me to use the Exocraft to get to that. Especially since I know I'd get stuck on a tree or caught in a hole or something like that. But if I take the ship, it works just fine, right? Okay. Alright. Inside. And loading transmission, witness price of heresy, fetch Now that there is no sky in which I cannot find you, no system to which flee unscathed, hide then in the depths of this galaxy, for we are patient. Know that your spawn wept like mewling geck as we cut them down, that we killed your consort as it fled, leaving the others behind to suffer. Where shall you ever find peace knowing these things? Okay. I must return and decide what to do before the transmission closes. I managed to pull the Exocraft mining laser blueprint. So I have, which takes Armadium. Of course it does. Why wouldn't it take Armadium? Okay, so now I have to find Armadium to get the mining laser. But that was some hardcore shit. Like, I was not expecting that. Okay, thrusters. Plutonium. Okay. Like, wow. Iron. Okay, so now I need to go back to my home base. Pick up the Exocraft. And if I see anything on the way that might, you know, resemble... Hello, there's this right here that makes sense to stop at. You know, because it does... Oh, shit, you're huge. Hi, big guy. You're peaceful, right? Most things on this planet are peaceful, except for the... fucking tentacle plants. Okay, yeah. I'm spending a lot of money on exosuit expansions. But where'd my ship go? Oh, it's over that hill. I know I'm spending a lot of money on exosuit, upgrades so that I can carry more stuff, but I need to be able to carry more stuff. Like, it's gonna take me a lot longer to get the stuff for my ship than what I need. Because, like, there's gold everywhere on this planet, and I can mine gold. Is that what's down there? I need to be able to see it. What is that? That doesn't look like what I need. Okay. Oh, boy. Okay, so let's head... Oh, gee. Oh, fuck. Oh. Suddenly I've forgotten how to fly. Okay. There's my base. Oh, jeez. Oh, fuck. Okay. Land. So, I need to take the Exocraft, I need to find some more Armadium. Let's hop in the Exocraft and see what else I need. So, I need Armadium for two things. I need it for the booster module. I need it for the booster module, which I need 20 for it, and I need Heridium as well, which I've got. Got plenty of Heridium. And I need two Karite sheets. It's going to be an issue. Well, it's just iron. And then 50 Armadium for that. So the thing is I need Armadium and I need iron. Hello. So while I'm thinking about it, since we're already here, I'll gather up the iron and make the Karite sheets that I need here. And then I'll go hunting for more Armadium. And then I'll build the mining laser. Sound good? Alright, I'll see you back here in a little bit. Look at that. I found Armadium. And a lot closer to home than the last one, but I went a different direction. I kind of sort of went the same direction as where I was sent earlier for the... to that signal to find out the dude's family had been slaughtered. Hi! Yes, I'm going to shoot. You have any friends on the way? No? Okay. What was in this? Nano neutrino module. Okay. Alright, so I've got the two Karite sheets, which, okay, I figured it out. In a vehicle, you can stack Karite sheets, but on your person, you can't. Which makes sense, but I'm stupid. So, alright. You need to move there. And I should have enough. Yes, for my mining laser. So if I then move you to there, I have enough for the booster as well. Okay. Okay, so if I hit G, it changes to the mining laser. And there's a giant deposit of gold right there that we can test the mining laser out on. Okay, I say giant deposit of gold, it would appear I've been here before. But yeah, this is still a lot better. Oh, actually, this is considerably better than doing it with the hand laser, because I can just keep going and going and going. Until I have filled up my reserves. So this is great. This is okay. Now the only problem is I can only aim so high. I can only aim so high and I can only aim so low. So I kind of end up missing large sections. But, oh, that's not what I wanted to do. Oh, I need to start remembering that it's not that button. But, you know, 185 gold just that quickly, that's pretty freaking awesome. Ooh, but it eats up a fuck ton of power. Okay. So, real quick, we're gonna head back to base. We're gonna talk to the Exocraft designer, I guess, the technician. We're going to go talk to him, and, well, one, I need to tell him about his dead family, and two, I want to see what the next thing he's going to give me is, because, to my knowledge, which, granted, my knowledge is not that vast, stop hitting that button, my knowledge is not that vast, okay, so, and, ooh. Ooh, and you can recharge with Thamium. Technology recharge. Yeah, Thamium's a great source of energy. To my knowledge, the only things he's got left to design for me are going to be the other two Exocrafts, one of which is the little hovercraft that has next to no inventory space. It's really only good for running and getting things quickly. It's real fast. It has a much better jump, because this thing, like, look, this has a jump. It can do that. That's all it can do. And that's, like, the extent of its booster. But you put the booster on the hovercraft, and it can, like, fly. It can get actually some pretty good distance with that. So the hovercraft is really good for doing things quickly. So if I need to run out, grab something for some reason, I can, you know, use the mining laser on it. Grab something real quick and then come back. I can do that with the hovercraft. But the other thing, the final thing, I believe the final thing, is the Colossus. And the Colossus is basically a giant tank, but it's got a massive inventory. It's also huge and super slow. Okay, so what do you got for me, man? Versions are almost complete, so no perfect myself with my old attachments. completely what it's become. They're all dead. Alright, leave me, traveler. My van keep prepared for death whole lives, but... thank you, friend, for what you have done. The next time we speak, I will be reborn. Sorry, dude. Can we talk again? What you got for me now? I am reborn without attachment. I can focus my focus anima. You require a mining laser I built, and now craft your Nomad Exocraft. Benefit for Acolyte of Null. Okay. So, this is the other... The Nomad. The Nomad is the little hovercraft. So, can you show it real quick? Okay, you can't really see anything on that. So I need a dynamic resonator, a volatic cell, and heridium. I have the heridium. I have something like 300 heridium. The cell is going to be a little bit of a challenge. But the dynamic resonator, I just have to go up to the space station for that. So, okay, I need this on me, not on my ship. So, but there we go. Volatic resonator. Ooh, I can make it. Cool. Oh yeah, the antrium, the cave flower that, yeah, because I just mined the shit out of those. Okay, so I need a dynamic resonator. I need to grab... Oh, I'm standing right next to it. I need to grab... The... What's your unknown starship? And you're now on my person. Yes. Yes, heridium. Okay. So now I just need to go up to the space station, grab a dynamic resonator, come back down, and then I'll build the Nomad. I wasn't expecting to be able to get it so quick. Where's my ship? So, I'll go up to the space station. I'll fly up there, fly back home, and we'll build the Nomad. Ooh, we're getting low on thrust. Might have to refuel this thing again. Okay. So there's the space station. One. Okay. Fly at the space station. Oh, God. Turn the ship. Turn the ship. Oh, God. Oh, this is terrible. Okay. Go in. Dynamic resonator. Love. Love, love, love that dynamic resonators are cheap. Well, at least on this station, they're cheap. In the Korvac system, they were not cheap. But on this system, they're decently cheap. So we can grab a dynamic resonator, build the Nomad, and then we'll call that the episode. Because the Nomad is... While it's kind of versatile, like I said, it has a small inventory. And with as small an inventory as is, the Roamer is still a more viable option unless I have to do something quickly. And I don't have to do anything quickly right now. So, but the Roamer is kind of the halfway point between the Colossus and the Nomad. Dynamic resonator. Okay. Yeah, the Roamer is the halfway point between the Nomad and the Colossus. It's not as fast. Oh, I want that ship. I know I can't afford it, but I want it. It's not as fast as the Nomad, but it has higher inventory, but it's not as much inventory as what the Colossus has, but it's faster. The Colossus is slow. The Colossus is like ridiculously slow. So, gold, iridium, heridium. Everywhere there's fucking heridium, so I don't know why you bother telling me that. Oh, God, I would not be wanting to make an approach this steep. Can't land, can you? Too high to initiate land. Okay, that's fine. That's fine. That land. Okay. Oh, that could have been terrible. All right, so let's build the Nomad. We're going to go build it over by... We're going to build its little platform... next to the Roamer's platform. So let's come over here. Why am I moving so slow? Okay. We'll drop the roamer there. Okay, so jump in here. Exocraft. Okay, Nomad. Yeah, there we go. Okay. And we'll build you... can I turn you? How do I turn you? Rotate R. You don't rotate. Okay. I would like... Yeah, that's what I want. So there's the Nomad. It, you can already tell, like, it's small. Compared to the Roamer, it's real small. Especially compared to my Starship, it's pretty small. So we'll hop in here. And that's all the inventory. It has 6 open slots, but it already has the accelerator built in. Okay, that helps. So the accelerator is already built in. So the only other thing... Oh, no. Okay. So I need the signal booster. And I need the mining laser. I don't need... The cannon. The cannon is not necessary. But the signal booster will be. So, okay. Back up. I think I can build... Yeah, bypass ship. There we go. Okay, so we can build a signal booster. Okay. So right now, I cannot build a mining laser on it. Because I don't have the Armadium for it. I don't have any. I need 50. I only have, like, 8. Well, you know what? Let's show you this thing real quick, though. So, like I said, it is a hovercraft. It can jump, and then you hit the booster, and it just flies for a little bit. It has some amazing controls. It drifts a little bit, but... Oh. So, it's not... the friendliest vehicle. It is not the most versatile vehicle, but it's fucking quick. It's small, it's light. So it has some serious advantages there. So whenever you need to do something, like whenever he's trying to send me, because I know it later on, I think he wants to send me out again on like one of those timed missions. So that's what, that's something we're using. We're using the Nomad would come in handy instead of the Roamer. Primary, yes. I want this to be my primary because it's still better. Because it has the laser right now. It has the laser, it has the weapon. And it still has quite a bit of stuff. But for now, we're gonna call the episode there. And maybe off camera, maybe on camera. I don't know. I haven't played this game since the last time I showed you, and I was originally going to be playing more so that I could get some of like the farming aspects out of the way, but I really didn't have to. So for now, thank you everybody so much for watching. Let me know what you think about the new vehicle, the new weapons, the laser, all that kind of stuff in the comments down below. Like the video, subscribe if you haven't, and I will see you next time.